At over a billion people and almost 20% of the world's total population, China has experienced one of the most rapid economic transformations in all of human history. Joining us on the show today is Jacob Shapiro. He's the Director of Analysis at Geopolitical Futures. And Jacob, before we get right into China and some of the implications of Trump now being elected and what's going to take place there, would you mind giving our audience a bit of background on the framework you use at Geopolitical Futures for understanding the geopolitical space, how you distinguish between things that are important for predicting what might take place and what's not important?
I would start by saying that Geopolitical Futures is the brainchild of George Friedman. So if anyone is familiar with George's work before, you'll be familiar with this methodology. But really what it all starts with is, well, it all starts with geopolitics. And geopolitics for us is not just a synonym for international relations, although that is often how it is used by many people, especially in the media, become kind of a fad word. For us, it's a methodology and it's a technique. It's about understanding the intersection between geography and power. Geography is sort of self-explanatory. Think of it in terms of the things that can't change, where a mountain is, where a river is, what that means for a country's economy, for its defense. And power really has, you know, only three real manifestations. We can talk about economic power, military power, maybe diplomatic power, although that's less important for us. And when you lay all these things out and you start thinking about geopolitics, you begin to see that history makes some sense and that you can try and see what's going to happen going forward, because most countries and therefore most political leaders have a limited amount of choices at their disposal. They may want to do a lot of different things. China's a great example of a communist country by ideology, sort of working in a quasi-capitalist economy right now because that's what they need to do. So we build a model based on geopolitics. That model is a forecast going forward. We have a forecast for 2017 or for whatever year is in front of us. We have a 20-year forecast and then a 40-year forecast.
Jacob, as I noted in the open, you know, China is a very important part of understanding the future of the geopolitical landscape. And, you know, there's a lot of eyes on China and U.S.-China relations. What do you and your team at Geopolitical Futures, how do you assess the situation and some of the concerns that people now have along these lines?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.